Good day everybody. In this video, I would like to explain how to estimate the active and passive pressure acting on the wall, which is in the soil mass that has cohesion. So we will start with the active pressure. And these are the formulas that we need to know. The first thing that we will do is we estimate the coefficient of active pressure. To do that, we will need to know the cohesion. And the cohesion is given as 30 degrees. We also know that the unit weight of that soil is 18 kilonewtons per cubic meters, and the soil, it's probably clay, it has cohesion of 10 kilonewtons per square meters. Okay, we'll start with the coefficient of active pressure. So I'm going to write it here that it will be 1 minus sine of 30 degrees divided by 1 plus sine of 30 degrees. So it's going to give us a value of 0.33. So what we do next, we're going to estimate this effective stress. A means active. And we're going to estimate at two levels. The first one at the surface where the wall starts, and the second one at the depth of 3 meters, where the wall ends. So let's look at the first one when we have this equal to zero. So right on the surface. In this case, if you look at this formula, you will see that this component depends on the depth. So if z is equal to zero, so this component will be equal to zero as well. I'm going to write it here. So active stress, it will be this coefficient of active pressure 0.33 times unit weight, which is 18, and times 0, because at a level of 0 meters, then it will be minus 2 times cohesion, which is 10 kPa, and square root of 0.33. So that should give us a negative value, negative 11.49 kPa. So this is going to be the level. So I'm going to write it here. So this will be negative. Goes to the left, negative 11.49 kPa. So now let's estimate the active stress at the bottom at 3 meters. So I'm going to say that this equals 3 meters. We're going to use the same formula, and we're going to write that this active pressure will be this coefficient of active pressure, which is 0.33 times unit weight, which is 18, times 3 meters. And then minus 2 times cohesion, which is 10, and square root of this coefficient of active pressure, which is 0.33. So according to my calculations, it should be a value of 6.33 kPa. Okay, so please note that here we don't have any groundwater level. So whatever stresses we obtained, total stress, effective stress is total stress minus pore water pressure. And because pore water pressure is equal to zero, in this case, total stress is equal to effective stress. So I can do next is I'm going to write this value will be 6.33. So you see that it's kind of very interesting shape. So it starts from negative and then change to positive. So at this point, when it changes the sign from negative to positive, we're going to call this point Z0. And we can estimate this point using this formula. So it means in the field that here, there will be active pressure. This triangular means there is no active pressure because of the cell's cohesion. And at this point, at point at this level, Z0, there will be some tension crack will appear. So if we're asked to calculate active pressure, we're going to estimate the area of this triangular. So not this one. So to do that one, we just need to know how to estimate the area. And I already showed in my previous examples, please watch my previous videos related to active and passive pressures. So to calculate the area of this triangle, it will be half of this value of zero here plus 6.33 and times as I wrote here 3 minus z0. So let's find this value of z0. We're going to use this formula and going to put numbers 2 times 10 and divided by unit weight of 18 times square root of 0.33. So that will give us a value of 1.93 meters. So this value will be 1.93 meters. So this value that we actually need to find, it's 3 minus 1.93 meters. So, and that will give us 1.07 meters. So what I'm going to do right now, instead of 3 minus z0, I'm going to write it should be equal to 1.07. And that will give us approximately value of 3.39 kilonewtons per meter. So that will be active pressure acting on this wall of 3 meters in this soil mass that has cohesion of 10 kilonewtons per square meters. Okay, so that was the first part. Now let's look at the passive pressure. So for the passive pressure, we don't have any changes in the sign, so it's always positive. The only thing that is different is this formula is slightly different. Here we have plus, and here we have minus. And also this formula to estimate stress, passive stress. So in this case, we're going to have this also plus here. Okay. The same procedure that we do, we're going to find effective stress at zero level where we have surface. And then we're going to have another stress here. So here it will be 0 meters and here equal to 3 meters. Okay, so let's do that one. So first, when it's equal to 0 meters right on the surface, if we put the formula here, so passive pressure, it will be, let's find the coefficient of passive pressure. I forgot to do that. Coefficient of passive pressure, it's 1 plus sine of 30 degrees divided by 1 minus sine of 30 degrees. And that should give us value of 3. So now let's go back and find this effective stress at the surface, effective stress for passive pressure. So we're going to put some numbers in here, and the numbers is already put coefficient of passive pressure 3 times unit weight times 0 because it's at the surface plus 2 times 10. It's still same soil, same cohesion, but the coefficient of passive pressure is 3. So that should give us value of 34.64 kPa. So now let's look at the level at the bottom of the wall when this equals 3 meters. So right at the end, at the bottom of the wall, In this case, this effective stress for passive pressure will be, we're going to have 3, which is the coefficient of passive pressure, times unit weight, which is 18, times 3, because it's 3 meters, and this component is the same. So you would notice that it doesn't change with the depth, it's still the same. And that will give us a number of 196.64 kPa. So if I come here back to this diagram, I'm gonna write here that this value will be 34.64 kPa. So that's the value that I use. And here at the bottom, we have much larger value, which is going to be 196.64 kPa that we just found here. Okay, so now we're going to find the area, and that will be the passive pressure acting on the wall. So the area is it's a half of the sum of 34.64 plus 196.64, and we multiply by this length, which is 3 meters. So my calculations say that it should be 346.9 kilonewtons per meter. So that will be passive pressure. Well, that's it for today. Thanks for watching this video. Have a nice day. Bye.